Hey you guys, this is Mr. Millings, and today we're going to learn about physical versus chemical properties. So let's jump right in and take a look at what physical and chemical properties are. Physical properties, it says right here, are properties of matter that describe the physical characteristics of a substance and not how the substance behaves chemically. All right, so physical properties will tell you how that substance behaves physically but not chemically. For example, if we said that aluminum foil is malleable, what does that mean? What does the word malleable mean? Well, it means that the metal is has the ability to be hammered into thin sheets. So we can take aluminum and pound it down into, or hammer it down into thin sheets. So that's not telling us how this aluminum foil is going to react with something else. That's just telling us how it's going to change physical form. So malleability or malleable is a physical property of matter. If we take a look at ductile or ductility, that is the ability a metal has to be turned into wire. For example, if we said copper is ductile, that would be a physical property of that copper. That's not telling us how it's going to chemically react with something else. If we said the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius, boiling point is a physical property. It doesn't tell us how that water is going to react or change chemically into something else. It's just telling us that at 100 degrees, this liquid substance is going to turn into water vapor, which is a physical change. All right, if we said the frequency of this wave is 20 hertz, well, then that would be a physical property of this wave. Frequency is the amount of wavelengths that pass a given point every single second. So that would be a physical property. If we talked about the viscosity of fluids, how some fluids are more viscous than others, for example, honey is more viscous than water. It has a higher viscosity. That would be a physical property of that. And last but not least, solubility. If we said salt and sugar are soluble in water, that is going to be a physical property of those substances. That does not tell us how the salt or sugar is going to behave chemically. All right, so physical properties are properties that describe the physical characteristics of a substance and not how the substance behaves chemically. Let's take a look now at chemical properties. Okay, chemical properties are a little different. Chemical properties are properties of a substance that describe how that substance's chemical composition will change given a certain specific set of conditions. All right, so if we take a look at a few examples of chemical properties, if I said gasoline is flammable, that tells you how that gasoline is going to react when exposed to an open flame. If we said a substance was radioactive, that tells you how the nucleus of that atom is going to change over time. If we said that something is corrosive, battery acid is corrosive, that tells you how that acid is going to behave chemically. If we said that a chemical was an oxidizer, which means that it has the ability to strip an electron off another substance, well, that would be a chemical property of that substance, right? So things like flammability, radioactivity, a substance being an oxidizer or corrosive, these are all chemical properties. If we said that oxygen is combustible, once again, that tells us how oxygen is going to react with an open flame, right? It's going to be converted into carbon dioxide and water vapor. If we said something is toxic, that too is a chemical property. If we said TNT is explosive, that too would be a chemical property of that substance. And last but not least, if we said that something is pyrophoric, that means that substance has the ability to ignite when exposed to air. So that will be a chemical property as well. So chemical properties are properties of a substance that describe how that substance's chemical composition will change given a specific set of conditions. So let's take a look at a few examples and see if you can determine whether they are physical or chemical properties of matter. All right, let's take a look at this little list here and determine if they are physical or chemical properties. And I advise that you go ahead and pause this video at this point and work through these yourself. See if you can figure out if these are physical or chemical properties. So freezing point, like we just got them saying, that's going to be a physical property of matter. That's not telling us how that substance is going to change chemically, right? If something is combustible, well, that's going to be a chemical change, right? If we said that oxygen is combustible, that tells us that oxygen over time is going to change to carbon dioxide and water vapor, right? If we said that sodium metal is water reactive, which it is, when you throw it in water, there's a very violent reaction. It's a chemical change that's taken place. So that water reactivity would be a chemical property of, say, sodium. All right, if we said something is viscous, that refers to a fluid's ability to flow, so that's going to be a physical property. If we said that a substance was toxic, that also would be a, that would be a chemical property. Condensation point, right? If we said that water begins to condense and turn back into, or water vapor condenses at 100 degrees Celsius and turns back into liquid, that is going to be a physical property. Physical property. All right, if something is pyrophoric, that means it ignites in air, that's going to be a chemical property. If something is corrosive, like battery acid, that's going to be a chemical property of that substance. And last but not least, if we said that the melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius, that too will be a physical property. That's not telling us how that ice is going to behave chemically. All right, so that is physical and chemical properties in a nutshell. If you like what you see, go ahead and click the little bomb in the bottom right-hand corner, and that will subscribe you to my channel. Also, if you have any sort of comments or questions, go ahead and leave them in the comment section down below, and I hope you found this helpful.